Oh, my name is Daryl Bolio, and I'm the chair of the Northern Aboriginal Business Association. Just a question, I want to give a little background first. Former Minister of Indian Affairs, John Quitchin, at one time said that if there's going to be any development in the north, it should be the people of the north that will benefit first. Former Minister Ron Irwin says the NWT is a regulatory policy and legislative quagmire. Honorable Jim Prentice, the latest minister, indicated that one of the biggest public policy failures in Canada was the failure to actually execute land claims and treaties. So with that, I think we're all aware that, excuse me, I got a little throat thing, that land claims implementation and treaty implementation is not a priority. It's actually on the back burner of territorial politics. And we all agree that regulatory policy and legislative clarity are keys to economic development here in the Northwest Territories. So I think it's important that the completion, the negotiation, the completion and the implementation of these claims are the underlying factor to any economic development in Northwest Territories. You always run into that. You know, you say there's regulatory problems, there's policy problems. You're always going to have that if you don't have the underlying factor resolved, and that's the ownership of the land and the clarity to move forward with. So it's a small cost of investing, you know, meaningful time and financial resources towards this initiative, which I think is the priority initiative of the whole North. Something that will generate employment, generate revenue for infrastructure, and create wealth for Northerners, all Northerners. And that's a small investment of maybe a few, maybe $10, $20 million, whatever it costs, to unlock the resource potential of the billions in the North. I think the diamond mines have generated a couple of billion already, and that's only with exploration of about 15% of the Slave Geological Province. Can you imagine what's in the other 85%? But the reality is you're not going to get there if you don't solve those issues. And with the NWT's majority Aboriginal population, one of the fastest growing in the country, and our demographics in the country, they're going to have a significant influence at the polls. So what actions would you take to ensure that complete treaty implementation and existing land claims implementation in the NWT if you are elected? That's it.
And which two ridings would you like to direct your question to?
Anybody that wants to answer.
First couple people with their hands up.
Okay.
Okay, okay. I'm going to go with the Welladay riding, Great Slave riding, and Yellowknife Center. Robert Hawkins was the first with his hand up, so we'll start with him. Go ahead.
Thank you, Jocelyn. Daryl, thank you for the question. I think it's a very important one, and I don't think the timing couldn't be better. Daryl, you know very well I support Aboriginal development, whether it's land claims or investment through economic development. I've spoken different times and all on the same song sheet, which is we have to speed up and finish these negotiations. I'm a firm believer that a lot of these negotiations have turned into economic development for the negotiators, and that's why they take years and never get solved. And I think anytime someone thinks it's going forward, they go, well, wait a minute, we should reconsult again. So what does that mean? They start over and it drags out. I think the determination of self-determination of Aboriginal governments playing a full partner in their development link is critical for the North's development, and I think they can be quality leaders in seeing future economic development for all. So in short, I would encourage the government to continue to encourage them to speed up negotiations, and if it took incentives, I think that's the way to get it done. We have to get them working and working in partnership with everyone. That'll drive it. Thank you.
Thank you. Arlene Hashi of Yellowknife Center.
Actually, I worked for the Dene Nation for a period of time, and I have studied and really have supported, obviously, the land claims process and the implementation of treaty agreements. I've noticed that not only is it not a priority for the GNWT, but they actually erect barriers to getting that job done. I find that the funding for the Aboriginal governing body that is attempting to make sure that that process is done fully and completely has been another underfunded effort. And to me, it should be the number one priority, and it should be properly funded so Aboriginal governments can participate as an equal partner in those negotiations that are happening around resource revenue sharing and that sort of thing. Thank you.
Thank you. On to the Welladay Riding, Paul Bromley.
Yeah, thanks very much, Darrell, for that question. I agree with the all the conditions you stated earlier that there's so many benefits to be had. I don't agree that the negotiations have become an industry unto themselves for those that are they're still at the table. And I thank the Northern Aboriginal Business Association for sponsoring this tonight, too. I think the main thing for me would be let's hook this to devolution. The federal government wants revenues and wants development, and GNWT, if it does proceed with devolution, hopefully with a majority or all Aboriginal partners, could hook that process to the resolution of land claims before development occurs, as essentially holding the federal government to the fire in a way to get moving on resolution of land claims. So that would be my focus, and I'd enjoy discussing that with the Aboriginal parties.
All right, thank you. Mark Bogan of Welladay.
Thank you, Darrell. I've certainly heard the frustration of constituents within Welladay on the unsettled land claims. It's certainly an important issue there. I agree. It's gone on and on and on and on and on. I think it first surfaced as rumor when I moved here in '82, and here we are 30 years later, and there doesn't seem to be an end of the road. Maybe Bob's right. Maybe if we hooked it to the federal government, it might speed it up with the majority government. I don't know. You know, Mr. Harper personally or anything, but or his position, that could be a solution. There's certainly, if that's not going to happen, then it's certainly a big problem here because it has gone on and on. And as I said before, the land claim settlement has to end during our next government. I'm out of time.
And thank you. Patrick Scott of Great Slave Lake.
Thanks, Darrell. Set the record straight. Land claims negotiations and self-government negotiations aren't delayed by the negotiators. They're delayed by government policy, both at the GNWT level and at the federal level. I will give you one example. 2 years ago, the DECHO tabled a resource management strategy with Canada. Canada and the GNWT still have not responded. That's inexcusable. Land claims need to be completed. Government needs to quit being obstructionist in getting it done. And I can, from my own experience, tell you that the policies of the GNWT do not enable quick settlement of land and self-government agreements. Thank you.
Thank you. And our final candidate on this question is Glenn Abernathy of Great Slave Lake.
Thank you. Thank you, Darrell. Thank you for the questions. In your question, you talked about policy clarity and exploration and development. I believe that a lot of the industry in the South isn't particularly interested in coming to the North because of that exact reason. They want to know the playing field. And until we get land claims settled, until the Aboriginal governments and the federal government and the GNWT can get to the table and resolve their differences and resolve land claims, industry is always going to wonder, and they'll always be slow to come. So we all need to work together. We need to find relationships, and we need to have leaders who are willing to meet and talk about the best interests of all people in the Northwest Territories. And I know they're out there. There's lots of people who want the same thing in the Northwest Territories, whether you're Aboriginal or you're non-Aboriginal. We can get there. We have to work together. To Mr. Bromley's point, I understand his point about tying the land claims solutions and finalization to devolution, but they don't need to be tied. We can continue to move forward on both of them with all of the partners at the table in the best interest of all people of the Northwest Territories, and that's what we need to do.
All right, and we'll leave things there on that question. Thank you so much for your question, Bill. Moving on to the next person.